The HR Centers of Excellence, or COE, data model organizes HR data, services, and processes into functional areas, providing many benefits. The HR COE data model consists of 7 tables that extend the HR case core table: employee relations, lifecycle events, payroll, talent management, total rewards, workforce administration, and ID operations. What are the benefits of having COEs? First, by separating these functional areas, you can configure data, services, and processes on each COE. Second, additional security can be configured on each COE to limit access to sensitive information. Third, COEs promote consistency for metrics and reporting by standardizing how cases are organized. The HR service determines the specific COE or case table where each case is created. Fourth, COEs help to drive automation by defining requests down to the service level. This allows cases to be automatically routed and assigned correctly, leveraging automated intelligence capabilities. So how does the COE data model work? Let's take a closer look at a COE hierarchy to see, using the HR payroll COE as our example. The payroll COE contains multiple topic categories, one of which is payroll administration. This topic category contains a topic detail, direct deposit, with several HR services tied to it: paycheck discrepancy, direct deposit setup, and direct deposit inquiry. These services correspond to the services that employees can select in the employee service center and that HR agents can select from in the case creation form. The HR service drives how the case is categorized and in what COE case table the case is created. This takes the guesswork out of figuring out how to categorize a case or which COE to pick, as well as promoting consistency for metrics and reporting. For these reasons, we don't recommend having just one general HR service. Now let's look at configuring and using the COE model. For each COE, you define your topic categories and topic details. For example, when we open the payroll administration topic category, we can see the topic details in this category. And we can set up a new topic detail right here. When we select one, we see the two HR services set up for it: direct deposit inquiry and direct deposit setup. When you create a new HR service, select the appropriate topic detail. The topic category and COE linked to that topic detail are auto-populated. Someone in your organization may request a new COE to meet a business requirement. How should you handle this? The structure and flexibility of the delivered COE model should make creating a new COE unnecessary. If you do get such a request, analyze the business requirement driving the request. Here's an example of how you can meet a business requirement without creating a custom COE. A business unit would like to offer services to its employees for submitting policy and compliance inquiries. Typically, requests around policy and compliance are handled either by HR operations or employee relations. For this example, the HR operations group handles these types of requests. This can be configured in the delivered COE model. In the base system, we already have a topic category, HR operations, that is tied to the HR workforce administration COE. Now let's create a topic detail for this topic category: compliance and policies. We can create HR services for this topic detail, such as a compliance/policy inquiry service, and configure these services to meet the requested business requirement. So by leveraging an existing COE, we've easily addressed a new business requirement. To learn more, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.